It is August 11th, 2019. Welcome to Vlogist.
Well, let's look at last night's blood sugar reading.
Definitely shouldn't have eaten more Doritos and don't even get me started.
I actually have an interesting story about one of the reasons it was so high. But first, let's look at this morning's.
Oh, wow. Bad, but not as worse as I thought. That's grammatically correct for humor reasons.
Too high, but... Wait, I already made that joke, didn't I? Well, look, I gotta wash my hair, and then maybe I can tell you the story here.
This is, of course, my Spirit Halloween Ghostbusters PKE meter, and I've modified it a bit. I did a video about it. I'll link in the description if I can remember. I still want to do a lot more mods. I want to put in a more film-accurate soundboard, which, once they become available, hopefully I'll have money at the time. And also, I want to replace these steady LEDs that are only on when this thing is on. I pushed the demo button. There we go. With ones which blink alternatively whenever the power is switched on. And I actually did buy two such LEDs. I bought them here at Vox Electronics, which used to be a Radio Shack. Although, interestingly, they stopped being a Radio Shack before Radio Shack stopped being a Radio Shack. You may remember a while back, the ceiling in this room collapsed because it's an old house. Maybe I'll put a link in the description. And the ceiling here in my bedroom also collapsed because I was up in the attic and... A lot of stupid going on both sides. Never mind the details. Well, I don't know if I have... Maybe I'll insert some video of what this ceiling looked like. My previous attempt to fix is too strong a word. Stave off the damage.
I put a bunch of Gorilla Tape up mostly, but I noticed that certain sections were really completely... disconnected from anything, and they were also pulling down the other parts thanks to the Gorilla Tape, and also some parts were secure, well, here especially, were secure in certain places, but not in others. So I strengthened this. Okay, let's see if we can see this here. Yeah, here I took Gorilla Tape and, this goes way under everything there. Or this goes under the... I'm not gonna do a second. Okay, here, this Gorilla Tape is going under the... I don't know how well you can see this. Don't know how well anything... Like maybe here. Yeah, this goes underneath... the ceiling plates. Here we go. You can see that. And then wrapped around the top. And as you can see here, I've reinforced it a bit with staple gun staples. I don't like touching fiberglass. And then I took out the heavier parts that were just pulling everything down. And that caused the problem.
How did I reenact this? Okay. Whoa!
Yeah, they fell and, knocked stuff off of things.
For example, here, I'm still missing some Doctor Who not Lego pieces. Do I see them there? What is that? Oh, that's... So, I don't know if they're under this stupid baseboard heater. Another thing men invented back when they didn't have to clean anything. And, well, there's still stuff here. Yeah. Eventually gonna have to actually move everything out. But I got a kitchen floor that people actually see, so who cares about here?
Pretty sure the LEDs were right around here. Pretty sure they got knocked off. Pretty sure I vacuumed them up.
So... Oh, I didn't mention that was a foam core. Just lightweight foam core, then held on with Gorilla Tape and also some white duct tape. And Also, I sprayed some of the Gorilla Tape. Didn't work too well. I went to Walmart in the middle of the night, and, well, they were cleaning the paint section, so it was roped off. There was a guy there, and I asked for two cans of, I think I specified Krylon white spray paint, but he just got me two cans of, I guess, whatever white spray paint was there, and I don't know if it might have worked the same if it was Krylon, but, you know, well, I guess that's the problem with a store being open 24 hours. I mean, you have to clean sections, which means that if you rope them off, they're not open, so the store isn't actually open 24 hours a day. You know, what happens when people are there in the middle of the night, technically the middle of the morning, wanting spray paint? Well, I think I just explained that, didn't I? So I came back here, and, well, here's the thing. I knew that they were closed on Sunday, but I didn't realize that
it's 3 p.m. on Saturday. Look, they're open till 6 normally.
But anyhow, the reason this ties together is because Vox Electronics is right next to
Vox Dairy Freeze. Yeah, sounds like a fake restaurant from a movie or TV show here. Yeah, it used to be a Dairy Queen, and as I pointed out before, their sign looks like a Dairy Queen sign with the Dairy Queen part broken off. I mean, you can see their wires up there sticking out.
Now, I think I must have been in there once before, at least, because I remember looking at their menu. I think I even took a picture. Maybe I'll insert it if I can find it. I noticed that they'd clearly taken images from online, and it apparently didn't occur to them that online images are only 75 DPI, which means if you blow them up to fit in a wall menu, they become 7 DPI.
Yeah, this looks it's a little hard to tell from the outside, but this looks professional now.
So I ordered a double cheeseburger combo, so that came with French fries. You know, the textbook example of empty carbs. And I also managed to do some reading, so now I know that if I have the screen on too long, the camera could overheat, and it will warn me, and it will also shut itself off automatically if I don't heed the warnings. I didn't know that, not good to know. Actually, now it makes me paranoid. I like to use the screen a lot, but then I remembered I don't take very long takes. In fact, I should take longer takes. Good to know, though. But back to the food there. First thing I noticed, white American cheese. Now, even uncouth heathens such as myself, who actually like American cheese, look down their nose at white American cheese. Oh, le fromage d'Americain, c'est blanc. Oh, oh. Or blanche, whatever. Hey. Y a-t-il quelqu'un là qui parle anglais? It was edible. That's about all I can say. It reminded me of school hamburgers, but I'm not sure if that's accurate because it's been so long since I had a school cafeteria burger. And I think those contained soy. I'm not really sure if that's true or not. I'm assuming these were pure beef, but I mean, they were definitely, I remember they used to advertise more burger than bun at Dairy Queen. Well, they're not Dairy Queen, but you know what I mean, though. I'm going to make comparisons to what they used to be. I think they were frozen and then defrosted in the microwave, and I had Diet Mountain Dew. I hope it was Diet Mountain Dew. I think it tasted like Diet Mountain Dew, although I haven't had not Diet Mountain Dew in a while, so hopefully they didn't mix up the nozzles in the machine there. We did get our own, which is good that way. But, you know, order a small and just keep refilling, you know, save a little money there, unless you don't want to make the trips, then I can. Point is, I'm not going back there again, although I was briefly thinking, ooh, you know, I should try the chili cheese dog. And no, they are too close to my home. I mean, and that was the one exception I allowed myself, and I didn't even follow it there.
As far as today's goals go, well, yeah, this floor is becoming a monthly goal, isn't it? But it shouldn't be too much longer. Just, I should have taken a before picture from exactly this angle so you could really tell how much cleaner, less dirty. Technically they both mean, no, cleaner means more than less dirty. It's still less dirty, it's getting to cleaner.
I did finally watch War in Space, or Wakusei Daisenso. Literally, Planet Great, the Great Planet War. Interestingly, the German title of this is actually a more accurate translation of the Japanese than the English title. I guess I
Well, I don't want to do a lengthy review, but yeah, this is... I mean, the special effects director actually said that he was inspired by Star Wars. Apparently, they saw... They saw it in Japan. I don't know if it was a screener or a bootleg or what it was, but doesn't actually say that they needed to get it out before Star Wars was released, which was in 1978, but it was released in December of 77, and that they had to get it out for in the New Year's time of year. So they had to do it quickly, so maybe that's implied. I mean, there's a Wookiee-like creature with horns. There's also an antenna called the R2 antenna. There's also some dubbed Gaijin, clearly dubbed, and but well, it's slow in place. It's not as epic as Star Wars. It doesn't take place a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. It takes place on Earth and Venus and the areas in between. Which, the planets are pretty close, as far as planetary proximity goes. In the future year of 1988, that's 11 years in the future back then. And basically this experimental Earth spaceship has to go destroy an alien base on Venus because the aliens from another galaxy who have a base on Venus are invading the Earth. And there's one thing, there's only one woman in the film as far as I can tell, and she gets captured, and it's kind of interesting to say, ah-ha-ha, now you must surrender or we'll kill this one person! And they are smarter than the people in Gamera versus Zegra. Now surrender your entire planet to us where we'll conquer you and eat you, or we'll kill these two children! Oh no, we can't let those two children be harmed, we better surrender the entire planet! Okay, it was a children's movie, but still... And the special effects are decent. It is Japanese, so some are better than others. Although I didn't notice any that really made me cringe. Of course, it also helps that I'm kind of a fan, aficionado of tokusatsu. So a lot of stuff, it looks interesting. But one thing about the ship, there are no shots of it here. I'm afraid. The sides open up and these revolver cylinders are there. And they're used for both launching fighters. Whoosh, kling, whoosh, and shooting zap rays. It's an interesting design. Whether it's practical, who cares? Well, I didn't get around to watching either of these, so that's, along with cleaning the floor and staying out of restaurants, my goal is to at least watch one of these, and this one's already in the player, and I'd started watching it before, so I should finally finish watching it, and I guess start over from the beginning, because I'm not sure where I left off before. It didn't save it. Yeah. Freaking Walmart.